ELISA stands for Enzyme-Linked Immune Sorbent Assay. At the end of this video, you will be able to distinguish between three different types of ELISAs. You will be able to explain what happens at each step of the ELISA and give examples of the use of ELISA tests. ELISA is based on the principle that antibodies recognize and very specifically bind to only one epitope. And an epitope is a very small part of an antigen, usually a protein or a carbohydrate. So imagine, for example, this bacterium here that has proteins on the outer surface and antibodies that will specifically recognize only one type of protein. If they accidentally bind to another protein, they will not recognize it. Note that even when the bacterium dies and breaks apart, the antibodies can still recognize the individual protein pieces. Attached to the antibody is an enzyme. That's why it's called an enzyme-linked antibody. We can detect the antibodies present by adding a substrate. The enzyme that's attached to the antibody will turn the substrate blue. If the substrate turns blue, that indicates that the antigen we were interested in is present. There are three different types of ELISA. In a direct assay, the antibody directly recognizes an antigen, and the enzyme is linked to that antibody. This is a very simple and quick method. This is not as sensitive because it only relies on one interaction between an antibody and an antigen. An indirect assay is more sensitive because it requires two very specific reactions. A primary antibody binds to the antigen very specifically, and then a secondary antibody recognizes the primary antibody. And it is the secondary antibody that has the enzyme then attached to it. In a third type, the capture or sandwich assay, three antibodies are involved. A capture antibody is bound to a surface. Once the antigen is added to it, that will bind to the capture antibody. And then after that, it's just like the indirect assay. A primary antibody will recognize the antigen, and a secondary antibody will bind to the primary antibody. In the assay we're going to be using samples of bodily fluids, and a negative and a positive control are added to an ELISA strip. The negative and the positive control are important to let us know whether the system is working in our hands. The negative control is a sample that we know for a fact does not have the antigen that we're interested in, while the positive control we know for a fact that it does have the antigen that we're interested in. At the end, we can compare the bodily fluid sample with the negative and the positive control to see whether it is negative or positive, so whether it does not or whether it does have the antigen that we're interested in. So in the assay, the sample of the bodily fluids, the negative and the positive control, are added to the ELISA strip. It is allowed to sit for 5 minutes, and then we wash away anything that was not bound. All the proteins in the bodily fluids in the samples will bind to the bottom of the well, regardless of whether it is the antigen or not. The primary antibody is then added and binds to the protein, the antigen, if it is present. If there is no protein present, there is nothing to bind to, and the antibodies will just float around in the liquids. Then the wells are washed, and after washing, only primary antibody that is bound to the antigen will remain in the well, and any free-floating primary antibodies will have been washed out. The secondary antibody is then added and washed in the same way, and the secondary antibody will specifically bind to the primary antibody. And after washing, only the secondary antibody that's bound to the primary antibody remains. In the last step, the substrate is added and allowed to sit for 5 minutes. The enzyme will turn the substrate blue. So in the negative control, you will see that the substrate should not turn blue because there was no antigen and therefore no enzyme. And in the positive control, where the antigen is present, you will see that the substrate does turn blue. You can then compare the sample that you're interested in, your bodily fluids, with the negative control and the positive control. If your sample does not turn blue, it is considered negative. If it does turn blue, it is considered positive. The negative and the positive control also help you to determine whether the test is valid. The test is valid if 5 minutes after addition of the substrate, the negative control is negative, and the positive control is positive. If the negative control is positive, you probably cross-contaminated the negative control with positive. If the positive control does not turn blue, you may have skipped a step. So your test is valid only if your negative control is negative and your positive control is positive. Once you determine that your test is valid, your test results of your sample can be interpreted. If your test sample did not change color, the result would be considered negative, and if it is positive, the result would be considered positive. ELISA tests are used in medical diagnostic laboratories to diagnose infectious diseases and allergies. You may be familiar with ELISA tests that are available over-the-counter, such as over-the-counter pregnancy tests, and there's an animation available at the link provided, and in-home drug tests to test for the use of illicit drugs at home.